Have you ever asked, do I only need to take one DNA test, and wondered what that answer was? Let me tell you what I think about this. When you ask the question, hey, do you need to take one DNA test, it sounds really simple. But I think that there are some complexities to this question. In other words, what do you really mean by that? Because there can be some different meanings. To begin, there's the type of test. What type of test is that what you mean? First off, there's the autosomal test, which is the most popular. About 30 million or so of these have been taken. Now, this looks at your entire genome, all 23 pairs of chromosomes in many cases, and looks at SNPs on each one to then be able to match up with other people. The next that people are most familiar with is the Y-DNA test. And this was actually the first DNA test that was commercially available, is looking at the male's Y chromosome. And again, it's looking at certain sections of that chromosome and the differences that they may have with others. So you can match with other people as well. Now, mitochondrial DNA has a specific test, which is similar to the autosomal test in that they're looking at specific SNPs on that or parts that might change between that. Now, the mitochondrial DNA is different from some of these others because there's actually just 16,000 letters on your mitochondria, whereas with Y-DNA, you're looking at 30 or 40 million, and with autosomal DNA, you're looking at sometimes hundreds of millions of letters on a single chromosome. And so there's thousands and hundreds of thousands of SNPs that you can look at. Now, the last one that I would also say is, well, there's SNP-specific tests. Now, some of these are used for certain medical procedures and diagnostics. Others of them can be purchased to look at a specific Y haplogroup or something of that nature. So if your question is do you just need one of these? Well, my answer to that would be is, what are you trying to find out? Because each one of these tests is really for a different purpose. Y-DNA and mitochondrial DNA are just for the patrilineal line or the matrilineal line. And they can go back a long, long time as far as being able to find matches. Whereas autosomal DNA, it's looking at all of your DNA, and so really your entire family tree, but just, you know, 5-6 generations back. After that, your autosomal DNA is not going to be very useful, if at all. And finally, SNP specific, there's lots of different SNP specific tests. So the question you really have to answer first is, why do you want to get a DNA test in the first place? And then you can start to look at each one of these tests to determine whether you just need one or if you need more than one. Before we continue, if you're new to genetic genealogy, chances are you have tons of questions. Be sure to check out the link in the description below for our free guide to the answers to the 5 most common DNA questions we are asked. Another question you may ask is, well, if I'm taking a test, let's just say an autosomal test, do I need to test with the different companies that offer these? And there's several companies that offer these. For genealogy, usually we're talking about Ancestry, 23andMe, MyHeritage, FamilyTree DNA, and Living DNA. You may be thinking, well, why would I need to look at any more than one of them? Because if it's an autosomal test, then all of them are offering autosomal tests, and isn't that the same thing? Well, let's go to the whiteboard and talk about that. So here, what I'm going to do is I'm going to draw a little Venn diagram, and we're going to start with Ancestry. And Ancestry is this big circle right here. Ancestry's got somewhere around 19 million, and that's how many are in their database. And so it's a real large circle. And if we go to the next one, and that's the next one is going to be 23andMe, and it's also a pretty big circle, but it's not as large. And what you start to notice is that, hey, there's some overlap here. And what this is this is where they are the same. And actually, I think 23andMe is around 13 million right now. So it's not as large as Ancestry, but there's some overlap. If we go to MyHeritage next, now MyHeritage is much smaller. They're only about 3 million. And again, you'll notice that there is some overlap. In fact, there is some people that have tested at all of these places. And again, if we go to Family Tree DNA, and I'm gonna do Family Tree DNA as more of an oval. Once again, we have some overlap in different places, and they're only about 1.5 million. And finally, we get down to Living DNA. And Living DNA is small. They haven't actually released their numbers, but I'm gonna give them this little sliver right here. And I'm gonna say that they are a 500,000. So with this diagram now, what we can do is we can say, let's test this. Or we want to find, let's say we're adopted and we want to find who our birth mother or father is. Well, there's going to be some people who are related to us in different ways. And the question then is how closely are they related and where have they tested? So if we use a little black to identify a bigger is more closely related and where have they tested, what we might find is we might find that there are these people all over that are one related to us, but also they've tested in different places. So for instance, if we just look at Family Tree DNA, there are two dots here within Family Tree DNA, and that's the matches that we have. Now, one of them is pretty closely related, and from that match, we might be able to find out how we are related. But what we can see is that if we test at MyHeritage, not only will we find those two, but we'll also find another person who is more closely related to us. But if we test at Ancestry, well, we actually have three that are pretty closely related, two of which were already in MyHeritage, and one of them was only in Ancestry. Additionally, we end up with these others from Ancestry that we wouldn't have gotten otherwise. But on the other hand, there's some of these here from 23andMe that are only in 23andMe. So the problem is we don't know where any of these black dots are beforehand. We don't know where our ancestors have tested. And so what that means to me is that should you test in more than one place? Well, if you're doing this for anything more than just the fun of it, I would say absolutely. I would test in all of the places because you don't know where your ancestors are. While Ancestry is the largest database, it's possible that all the ancestors that you're looking for, except for one or two, are over in the MyHeritage database. But until you actually test with MyHeritage, you're not gonna know that. It might be that there's none. And so you've really need to answer the question of why is it that you're testing? What is it that you're hoping to try and find out? Now, the question, do I only need to take one test, could be taken a number of other ways as well. I've answered what I think are probably the two most common ways that you're asking this question. And the answers to that is, well, it depends on what you're trying to find out. And that's going to determine what kind of test you need to take and whether or not you need to take a test from more than one place. Now, if you would like to learn about what DNA testing company I think is the best, there's a video up at the top here. And if you'd like to learn about something else with DNA, then there is a video down below. Be sure to check out the link in the description below, which contains a free guide.